Good morning and welcome back. You're watching Morning with Life. Marv Qureshi ke saath sabse flight Asia pe khush aamadeed kehte hain ji aapko. Lekin aage jaane se pehle aapko batate chale meri aaj ki mehman shakhsiyat ke hawale se jiska introduction maine abhi aapko program ke aagaaz mein bhi diya. Aur main dobara thoda sa repeat karna chahungi. Bahut sare aise log hote hain jo ke अपने आप से बढ़कर दूसरों के लिए बहुत कुछ सोचते हैं और अपने उसी 24 घंटे के दिन को इस तरह से यूटिलाइज करते हैं कि हम हैरान रह जाते हैं. ज़िंदगी में कोई ना कोई एक ऐसा छोटा वाकया ज़रूर, छोटा नहीं, खैर बड़ा या छोटा, लेकिन डिपेंड करता है कि सब तक आपको इफेक्ट करता है कि उसके बाद आपकी ज़िंदगी का जो रुख होता है वो ही बदल जाता है. एक ऐसी ही आज पर्सनैलिटी से आपको मिलाएंगे जिसको 9/11 के अटैक्स ने इस हद तक इफेक्ट किया कि उसने वॉलंटेरिली अपनी जो अपना अपनी अपने आप को पेश किया वहाँ पर. ही इज़ एन अमेरिकन नेशनल. उसके बाद दुनिया में जब भी कहीं भी कोई भी आफत या कहीं भी कुछ ऐसा हुआ जहाँ पर वॉलंटियर्स की ज़रूरत थी तो इन्होंने अपने आप को वहाँ पर सर्व करने के लिए पेश किया. एंड 2005 वाज़ द टाइम व्हेन अर्थक्वेक हिट पाकिस्तान और यहाँ पर हमें बहुत सारे वॉलंटियर्स की ज़रूरत थी और इन्होंने तब भी अपने आप को सरेंडर किया और यहाँ पर 2005 में ये आए. लेकिन उसके बाद ये यहाँ से वापस नहीं जा पाए. नॉट बिकॉज हम लोगों ने इनको जाने नहीं दिया, बट बिकॉज ही नेवर वॉन्टेड टू गो. लेकिन यस, वन ऑफ द रीजंस वाज बिकॉज पाकिस्तानी जो थे वहाँ से इनको इतना प्यार मिला कि इनका ये कहना है कि उसके बाद मेरा यहाँ से जाने का दिल नहीं किया. और आज एक बहुत ज़बरदस्त हॉस्पिटल रन कर रहे हैं ये हमारे नॉर्दर्न एरिया के अंदर, जो जहाँ पर अर्थक्वेक हिट किया था, और वहाँ पर बहुत सारे लोग जो हैं इनके हॉस्पिटल से मुस्तफ़ीद हो चुके हैं. इनकी स्टोरी आज इनसे जानेंगे. पहले ये सिंगर थे और सॉन्ग राइटर थे और अब भी इस जॉब को वो साथ लेकर चलते हैं, लेकिन कोशिश करते हैं कि अपने म्यूजिक के थ्रू अब ये लोगों को इंस्पायर कर सके. वेलकम टॉड शेयर. हाय टॉड, हाउ आर यू?
हाय, थैंक्स फॉर हैविंग मी.
थैंक यू फॉर कमिंग. इन फैक्ट एंड टॉड, योर स्टोरी इज जस्ट सो इंस्पिरेशनल. वेल, आई वाज एक्चुअली सर्चिंग फॉर यू ऑन गूगल. आई वाज टोटली इम्प्रेस्ड. हैट्स ऑफ टू यू फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल फॉर बीइंग एबल टू सर्व फॉर सच अ बिग कॉज, humanity. How did it all start?
Well, had a concert scheduled for the day after 9/11 in New York City. So instead of that concert, I woke up the morning of September 11th and from my hotel room saw that Twin Towers on fire.
Yeah.
So I decided to use my vehicle, which was a large van. I took my equipment and my musical instruments out of it and went down and started helping out, bringing in supplies for the firefighters and people dealing with that situation.
Okay.
And after working there for a week, I wasn't really needed anymore, so I left. Okay. But that imprinted on me and changed me forever. Music was not important to me anymore as a pursuit of a commercial career.
But earlier to that, those 9/11 attacks, you were totally into music and you were a different person.
Well, I think I'm the same person. I'm still a musician, but I learned something about myself during that disaster, that I was also good at logistics, and in a very chaotic, terrible situation, I was able to do some good. So learning that about myself, I was able to pursue that when other disasters happened.
Okay.
So I went to tsunami in Sri Lanka, Hurricane Katrina, and then, of course, Pakistan earthquake. I've been just recently to Japan right after their earthquake and tsunami. And to Haiti, within just a few hours after the earthquake there, I was on a plane, airplane, and went there. So basically, that's how it all started. But a lot of people ask me, why did I stay in Pakistan?
Absolutely.
When I just
this
visited
is like the one
these
question anybody has. Yeah.
Well, I think that I got on ground, and I realized very quickly that I was only going to stay for 2 weeks. Then I realized very quickly that the devastation and the challenges, both logistically and for the people, were very, very big. But I stayed for longer. 2 weeks turned into 2 months. But then during that 2 months, I really fell in love,
Mohabbat
for the children of Pakistan. They were very badly injured, and it was the first disaster where I had seen that many. And then the people in the village, people in the Pakistan Army, people in UNICEF, all these people asked me to stay longer, that I was doing a good job, please stay,
yeah,
you're doing wonderful. And so I blame the Betreen, Kubsaret, and Zabardast. Pakistani bachi.
Thank you so much.
This is why I've stayed.
Bachi is used in another sense also in our country, you know that.
No, I don't.
Yeah, that's like, you know, the chicks.
Oh, no, I mean the baby.
The kids.
The baby.
Absolutely fantastic. Dr. Saab, since Dr. Humayun is in a rush and he'll not be able to join us in the next segment, I just want to, you know, just know, how do you feel, you know? It's just so inspirational, the story.
That's true. Actually, there are three levels, or let's put it like this, there are four levels of a human being, right? Level one is when you are making money, going out to the world, bringing money, looking after your family. If you're doing only this, you're no different than any animal on the planet.
True.
Right? The day you go out and help somebody out of your immediate family, you become a human, because then you go and help somebody else who is not related to you.
Absolutely.
So that is the second stage. Right? That could be a one person or a one family, but not bigger than that. The third stage is when you are helping someone which is within the geographical boundary. That could be, let's say, a small little street people, a small little village or a town, or maximum a country, but it is within a geographical boundary. And the fourth stage of the people are those who do something for the humanity, like all the prophets, like all the, you know, like Alexander Fleming, like all these people, you know, who have Louis Pasteur, who have changed the things for humanity, for the people who would be living. Now, what he is doing, that is certainly the third level of the level in humanity, as far as I you know, sort of divide it, right? And I think it's very important that we all must learn from people like Todd, that he is thousands of miles away from his family, from everyone, and he is, you know, helping people out. Now, that is in reality the real humanity, and that shows how nice a person is from the inside. He is, you know, and as you said, hats off to not only to him and all the people like him who has traveled thousands of miles away to help people, to be the ambassadors of the peace, to really see them.
Ambassadors of change, you know, I must say that, because what happens is that normally you do get this feeling of like helping others, but with the passage of time, the feeling vanishes and you just don't wanna, but as compared, if we talk about Todd, he has not only been serving himself in Pakistan, but around the world. So like the motivation that he has is remarkable. Todd, like, well, where does the motivation come from?
Well, that motivation is usually from his, as he said, he discovered something about himself, right?
So this incident was
exactly,
like, you know.
It's just like, you know, one of our, the caliphs, Hazrat Ali, he said that if you discover yourself, you will discover God, right? So that is what it is. You actually have to first discover who you are.
Yeah.
So
I have a book of his wisdom.
Yes, exactly.
Excellent. That I read.
Right, exactly. So, you know, he discovered himself that, look, I have got something in that 1 week. He discovered that he has got the skills that he can manage things at the time of chaos and everything. He can keep his nerves together and he can do things. That was brilliant. Not everybody can do it.
Exactly.
So, you know, that is what is important. He discovered something about, and then the passion of helping people, the passion of having selflessness and being more towards other people probably was always there. And it just sparked, it just ignited, and then you can see the fire now.
Well, my mother was a kind of person who anyone would love. She would give, if she had last dime, last dollar, she would give it to somebody else if they needed it more. She died when I was 12 years old.
Oh.
So I know the pain of loss. And so to be able to help people that are going through that same pain, whether they're in Pakistan, whether they're in America, doesn't matter. They're human beings.
Oh my God, I know what to say. I've lost my words. But yes, you're right. There are moments in life which actually make you realize why have you been sent to the earth? There are people who spend their entire lives not being able to know the very basic truth. Why are they being sent on the earth? Look at Chod, aap inki story sun rahe hain. Ke kehna basically yehi hai ki ek life mein koi na koi aisa incident zarur hota hai jo aapko ye sochne mein majboor kar deta hai ki aapko is duniya mein bheje jane ka maqsad kya hai. Aur bahut early stage ke andar when he lost his mother, he realized ki in ke kya hota hai, you know, the pain of loss basically. Aur uske baad se zindagi jo hoti hai wo tabdeel ho jati hai. Yahan par ek break lete hain, Chod ki story hum zyada bhi mazid continue karenge, kuch unki family ke bare mein bhi janenge, because jab se ever since you've been to Pakistan, you know, I don't think so anybody's asked you about your family, who you used to be and what are your future plans and your music and all that, so we're going to be like, you know, getting to know you more as a person also. So wow, that's awesome. Theek hai ji, aur hum isko continue karenge. Doctor saab ko hum ijazat chahenge. Doctor, thank you very much for joining us. I know you're niraash, so zara hum se farigh kar rahe hain.
It was nice meeting you.
Great to meet you.
And I'll tell you something, Chod happens to be a fan of Imran Khan also, and you know, he's taking part in the activities jo Imran Khan sab kar rahe hain ji different areas ke andar, because hame pata hai ki wo bhi Pakistan ke bahut bade philanthropist hain. And it's just so good to see Dr. Humayun also, member of the same political organization, and two people sitting here admiring Imran Khan, me being the third. So we need some time for that. We'll take a break. You can call in and join my Facebook page, Morning with Life ke naam se. Break lete hain. Break ke baad hum story ko, jo Chod ki story hai, usko jaari rakhenge. Have a lovely morning. Have a great day ahead.